So let's say 19 times, let's say 19 times 5, that's rounds it out nicely. Five times six. So I could create 570 pounds worth of marble of stone, roughly. Just round down to 500 pounds and crush the skeletons under that. That should be able to shatter them enough that we could then burn them up.
I don't think it's real complicated. We just, grab some rocks and start smashing the bones. Put them in a big pile and smash them up.
You're assuming I would deign to actually pick something up. Dude, when I can just summon stone from...
I will do it. I'll grab some rocks and I'll start jumping up and down on them.
Well, I mean, yeah, sure. I mean, my method just would only take like 30 seconds to do. Or 36 seconds since it's 6 rounds.
Oh, okay. I thought Tyler was saying it's going to take a while.
Nah, I could... There's 10 of these, so I could crush them all in like around 5 minutes or so.
Oh, okay. No problem.
No, I was just being a smartass earlier.
Trying to figure out which of the society traits to pick, because I forgot to grab one of those. They're all pretty bad. Like, really bad.
There are a couple of decent society ones. But not many, I agree.
Maybe I should pick the tireless one that gives you an extra hit point.
Yeah, if you were a monk, you could take Honor Fist of the Society, which gives you another key point, but you're not, so.
Yeah, actually, I'm going to check in Hero Lab for Society feats. I might find some better ones in there.
You might. And we lose Danes once again.
He said he was going to go reset his router.
Yeah, but he just logged in and then logged back out again.
Ow.
Thing popped up in the Google chat and then went away again.
I logged on to Eve to see if there was anything new with the war.
Tell me how to play Black Belly. It's really good.
I'm not a huge fan of the combat system.
Okay. Fair enough. Most people like it. Because it's more action-oriented than most MMOs.
My issue is I have a hard time keeping track of the button combos. So I'm really bad at it.
That takes practice. I will agree with you on that one. So what were you playing? What class did you try?
Sorceress.
Well, no wonder. That's the hardest class of all to play, with the hardest combos.
So you're telling me I just picked the coolest sounding, but the absolute hardest to play.
Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying. Yeah, Sork is really good in later game PvP, but they're definitely the hardest to play. But if you can master it, they are very good in PvP.
What do you think of Soul Drinker, where once per day I can gain temporary hit points equal to the hit dice of a slain enemy?
That's a society trait?
Sounds pretty evil, honestly.
Well, I mean, it's from the Dark Archive.
Sounds pretty evil to me.
Yeah.
If it's from the Dark Archive, I don't Does it say it's evil?
No. I mean, I'm just drinking souls. It used to be a Chillaxian one. Yeah, it's pretty evil.
It sounds evil.
Hey. Don't judge just because I enjoy the fine taste of a ripe soul every now and then.
Yeah, sometimes you gotta judge. Sorry, dude.
Yeah, it doesn't fit the character either.
No, I agree with them.
I'm surprised they even created that trait, because Pathfinder Society has like a hard and fast no necromancy rule.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they typically do.
I'm not at all a fan of what they do in society rules.
Are you telling me that the necromancy school for wizards is out?
You can't play an evil character, and you can't do the necromancy spells that, as a player, you can't, like, summon undead, basically. And I think almost all the necromancy spells that are evil are going to be a problem for them as well, if I remember right.
Makes sense to me. They are pretty anti-evil character, I've noticed.
Yet. Yeah. Are we all back?
Well, James isn't. Which one of you is Skeevik, by the way, on Twitch?
Tyler?
Oh, you are, okay.
Have we peaked more than two people?
We had seven at one point, I think.
Yeah.
Then I had to restart my stream, and they're all gone. Nope.
Is it just the three of us? Is it just what? Three of us in there now?
I think so, yeah.
Yep. Yeah, there's just three people in. Sovereign Court doesn't exist any longer, does it?
What is Sovereign Court?
A faction.
Oh, never even heard of it. But I haven't heard of both of them, so.
They create new ones and retire them pretty often.
Give me a second, I'm looking. We got the Dark Archive.
Yeah, I think Sovereign Court's gone.
Liberty Edge, Scarab Sage, Silver Crusade. Nope, it's there.
Oh, it is there?
Yep.
Okay, let's look. Shall I be fashionable? Does it actually help me at all? I'm just going to take the one that gives me an extra HP. Tireless. +2 trait on constitution checks to resist non-lethal damage from swimming, forced marches, starvation, thirst, and hot or cold environments. +1 HP.
That may not be bad.
That puts me at an even 40 HP from a character. Well, so if we do choose to rest for the night, I have a pavilion tent.
You're going to put a tent up in a cave?
We could go outside.
We could go outside.
We are right in the entrance after
all. Are we going to do anything about this chest before?
Oh, yeah. The reason I wandered in there in the first place last time.
Yeah, unguarded chest in the middle of a cave.
Right. So
nothing suspicious about that.
No, not at all. I'm going to check it for traps. And what is my traps roll? Let's see here. And I'm going to take 20 on it. Or can you do that with traps?
No.
Okay. Then I'll just roll it.
Roll initiative.
Uh-oh.
Initiative?
Mimic.
No, Jeff wandered up and...
Dude! Let me open the chest first.
Let's run. Book it for the door.
Why did you have to wander? All right.
I didn't think there's more to this particular cave. I should have known better.
Yeah, look at what happened to me last time.
What did I say about this cave taking a couple of weeks?
When did you say that?
Earlier tonight.
Great.
We are screwed.
If these are anywhere near as tough as the last guys, yeah, we are.
That's okay. You hear a shout from Alisa to run.
Oh, fuck. Run!
Everyone got initiative rolled?
Yep.
I don't see never mind. Yep, everyone has an initiative roll.
And you know what the worst part is? We never found your old corpses. Or your loot.
Nope. Just keep running.
You haven't had a chance to look yet.
It's true. Though they might have been in the chest.
We can actually survive this if we run.
Hmm. Alright, so... Archer. 25 to hit Jeff.
Yes. It's an 18 is a number.
Okay. One damage.
Dink. No damage.
Caine?
Where did you go?
I'm over here.
Okay.
So, free action to shout, run, many more skeletons.
Okay, I still don't see you. Or no,
you would hear me from over
here. I don't see any skeletons. What? It's daylight outside, right, Tyler?
Yeah.
So, just so you know, I see many skeletons.
Okay. Run and put a barrier behind you.
Yes. I tell you. Well, and that's not going to help.
Yeah, it'll hold one for around. It'll hold one. What?
No,
if you put it, like, right here...
The passageway is too wide.
Enough. No, right here is just wide enough.
Okay, that's right two there. Squares.
No, right, like right here.
It's two squares.
Here?
Yeah.
No, yeah, because it would have...
One square, it's a half of two squares. It's one square.
I'm thinking there's something we can't see based on the formation there.
Huh. Okay.
Two squares.
Well, shit. Okay. Run as fast as you can. I'll cover you.
What are you doing?
Just keep running. Just run. Trust me, just run.
Hmm. Alright, I'm going to... Where is our
run, Caine. Run.
No, I know that. Where are you, Nissel? You're right below me. I'm going to grab you and drag you along with me as I run.
But I'm going to cast Hide from Undead and cover his butt.
No, you are going to run.
Actually,
I knew
that's
you
a very
do something like that, so I'm grabbing you, and you are running.
All right, grapple check.
All right, we can do that.
No, Hide from Undead's perfect. They're not intelligent undead.
Aren't they?
I don't know. I'll give them a grapple check.
Skeletons are almost never intelligent undead.
Oh, well.
You're not grappling.
Nope, I'm not grappling. Come on! Let's go!
As Nizzle uses his amazing kung fu skills to deflect your hands.
I'm an archer, okay? I'm not a very good monk. Anyway, that's my action.
Okay.
And I'm basically doing a move action. If Nissel doesn't want to go with me, then I'm running without her.
4 damage, Jeff.
I take 2.
Yeah.
Okay. Jodorski?
I've been through this cave.
Yes.
Oh, my turn.
It's your turn.
Everybody's saying to run, but I don't want to leave these skeletons behind, so yeah. I...
Run!
I go over here and I pick up the skulls of the one I'm standing on and this guy right here.
You know, guys, we have one chance to run from this, and you guys are wasting it.
I am running. I am running with a couple of skulls, though, so these guys don't get resurrected as soon as we leave the room. Okay?
Why don't you just stab them with your pole arm on the way out?
No, I already took time to crush them.
Yeah, I thought that, I remember him doing
that. We figured out it was going to take 5 minutes. I took 5 minutes and crushed them all.
Okay. All right, I was just worried about it.
They are a fine powder. It would take a significant amount of spellcasting to restore the things.
All right, then. Everybody run. I will hold up the rear.
That's what she said.
All right, Skeleton Archer number 3. Misses. Skeletal Fighter charges. Misses.
Okay. Okay, my turn. Withdraw action, so you don't get the attack of opportunity. 5, 10, 15,
20, 25,
30, 35, 40. Okay. Oh, God, you're a dwarf. You can't run for shit. God damn it.
Well, I withdrew.
That's the same speed that I do.
I can run.
Yeah, you run as fast as I walk.
Okay, sure.
Invisible?
No, that was a double move. I can run for 4 times my speed.
Mm. Your full move is as much as my move.
Mm-hmm, I know.
Nizzle?
Well, seeing that Jeff is now here... 2, 3. I'm gonna move here.
Just everyone leave the cave.
So in other words, you should have just gone with me in the first place. Instead, you made me grapple. Or try.
Caine.
Mm-hmm. What about me?
It's your turn.
Oh. Jodorski and Alisa are still not out.
Yeah.
Jodorski. Okay. I'm going to fire at this skeleton. And how far away is he? 50. Alright, so I just don't get the one flank bonus at all. Well, I think I still hit.
You hit him. Did you confirm?
Yes, I did. So, wow, bows are times three, aren't they?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, 30 points. Kaboom.
Huh.
Bones go flying everywhere.
The only time that you hit something.
I know. Yeah. I murder it.
Well, it is when you're trying to get the fuck out.
Yeah, essentially.
Jodorski?
I will ready an action for when Alisa gets past me. I will follow right behind him. Or her.
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 Charge! As he stumbles.
This is a refreshing change from last week, I gotta say.
Alisa.
I withdraw. 5, 10, or 10, 15,
20, 25, 30, 35,
40.
You don't
want to
mount Caine again?
Okay, well, I'm assuming he's in the wrong.
Caine doesn't like to be mounted.
Guys, wait for it. Get out.
Caine doesn't like to be mounted by dwarves?
No, definitely not. Especially gender confused ones.
No, she has a rather feminine dwarven voice.
Jeff? No, you don't. All right. Who's next?
You guys make it out.
They don't follow us?
Not out of the cave.
Okay. Well, so now can you do that, hide from undead, and go look at the entrance and see if they went back to their room or if they're still standing in the front room?
Yeah, it lasts for a half hour when you cast it.
Yeah. Just don't attack them, just look and see where they are.
Yeah, you can't touch them, you can't interact with them at all, but they won't be able to see, smell, hear you.
Yep.
And I'll be right back.
Mm-hmm. Gamma roll initiative.
I'm hiding from undead.
Well, you think you're hiding from undead. Is that one charges you?
Whoops.
Okay.
So I guess they stayed in the front room.
Hold on. He charged me. Ho. I have a buckler with a spike on the shield.
Yeah, but you have to have that set before he charges you.
Alright, fine. He doesn't hit.
Yeah, yes he does.
What?
Plus, that doesn't have the charge bonus on it. Add the plus two for the charge bonus.
That's equal to my AC. Doesn't equal defense hits. Win? Equal no. hits.
Equal hits.
Okay.
For nine.
Jeez. Okay, I'm back.
Well, I'm going to take that nine damage and just hightail it out.
So I take it the skeletons are back?
Yeah, they didn't apparently... they can apparently see right through his invisibility. Somehow. And they were still waiting in the front room.
Well, I assume they'd be waiting in the front room.
I figured they'd go back to... I figured they'd reset and go back to their own room.
This isn't World of Warcraft.
Oh, come
I guess
on,
not.
Right? They only have like a 30-foot aggro radius.
They are literally mindless automatons.
Yeah, if well, anything was going to have like, wow, it would be these guys, I would think.
Well, if they were able to see through your spell, did they make the will save to do so? They can't just automatically bypass hide from the dead. Well, it's not invisibility. It's
the
an effect
undead
that,
equivalent, I guess.
Well, no, it doesn't work at all like invisibility. It's literally the senses of the undead just don't work.
Hmm.
It's true. Well, no, will negates.
Yes, a will negates it if you made the will save. But only intelligent undead get to make that will save.
These guys
unintelligent might be- ones are automatically affected by it.
I say we run out of the cave and go, you know, set up camp.
Yeah. 8 hours of rest. But, yeah, so undead cannot see, hear, or smell creatures warded by the spell. Even extraordinary or supernatural sensory capabilities cannot detect or locate warded creatures. Non-intelligent undead, such as skeletons or zombies, are automatically affected and act as though the creature was not there. Intelligent undead gets a single will save.
Well then, this is the DM saying, fuck off.
Just you wait until I get to treat the world like Minecraft. I'm going to manually tear apart every dungeon you throw at us. Not magic.
You've been GM bombed.
It's the power of the mind.
All right, just to avoid getting into this next combat without time to finish it.
Well, right. let's heal up and then repeat the plan.
Yeah, pretty much.
Rinse and repeat.
It worked the first time.
Yep.
And had a reasonably and did reasonably well. Although this time I would say put up more barriers if you can.
Well, I can only do six.
Oh, we didn't raise a level.
Oh, nope. True. I could do seven if we leveled up.
Did we raise a level?
Nope.
Damn. I was hinting. Oh well.
So it's just a tier then.
Well, two cure light wounds should heal both of you up fully.
Yeah, I was going to say we need full 8 hours to get spells and stuff back.
Yeah. I'm just saying the kill light wounds before the 8 hours. And then we rest up outside. I have a comfortable pavilion tent, so...
Do you have cure light wounds, or should we use the wand?
What wand?
The wand was on Beakdown.
Oh. I hope you have cure light wounds.
He gets it automatically.
Okay, good.
I've played a few oracles in my day.
Fair enough. I never have.
Of course, mine were of the Dark Tapestry, so, you know... They gain their powers from Lovecraftian monsters from beyond the known universe, but still.
never been much into playing healers, to be honest.
Yeah, oracles you can do a lot with. They don't even have to be healers.
No, I know. I've seen some good damaging oracles. Just still not my character type usually.
I have one character that no one's let me play, which is a mermaid oracle of the flame.
Wait, what?
Okay. Yes.
Now I think we're just getting ridiculous.
Yep.
Well, no, well, it's a great character because the mermaid at level 7 has a fiery body and flies on wings of fire.
And yet is a mermaid. Okay.
And is a mermaid, yes.
All right, so we go outside, we heal up, we go take our naps.
We come back.
Yep.
Okay.
While you're napping,
mm-hmm.
a squirrel comes up to you.
A squirrel.
Okay.
A squirrel.
Does the dog next to us say, squirrel?
Do you want to clear away the dead skellies?
No, we're outside.
Well, I thought we came back now. We just took care of it real fast.
Do you guys really want to start that combat now?
No, I'm fine for it.
It only took us, 2 hours through the last one.
Well, let's start in the middle of it next time. We have to stop.
Yeah.
What else are we going to do, Tyler?
I don't know.
Unless we can find a different way in.
And we killed one of them, so we might be able to do this a bit faster.
Actually, you know what? While they're resting, I'm going to scout a bit. I'm going to see if there is another way in. Need a perception review?
Nope.
Okay.
You don't find another way in.
Okay.
Well, I'm setting up my barriers again.
How many times a day can you put those up?
It's at will.
At will and with no limit.
Mm-hmm.
That's interesting. Okay.
Pretty much everything. So I'm like the warlock. I have a mechanic called burn, where some of my abilities require burn, and if I don't mitigate it by taking extra turns for the actions, then each point of burn costs me 3 of my HP per, or 1 HP per level, basically. But this kinetic cover ability that I have costs 0 burn, and it's just standard action. So I can just keep doing this.
Okay.
Other things that, though, would wind up costing me some of my HP. And I'll let you know when things cost burn. So, setting it up like we did last time. B- But remember, I can only maintain 6 of these. If I cast a 7th one, then the first one that I cast would just disappear. Crumble the earth. But no, it's pretty cool.
You guys have no interest in what's in that chest.
We can't get to it.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to hang back this time.
Every time we touch it, we get attacked.
Well, it wasn't touching if it got you attacked last time. It was Jeff wandering deeper into the cave.
So are they still sitting in that front room when we come back?
You don't see anyone there.
Well,
yeah, we don't actually see anyone. Detect
undead.
I'm just going to... Yeah. Okay. Since I'm the toughest, everyone hang around the entrance real fast, and I'm going to stealth my way forward.
Wait.
James, I have a good stealth score.
That's fine. James, can you cast Detect Undead?
Yes.
It's a first-level spell, though. Do we want him to use up a first-level spell?
Yeah, because I want to know where they are before they see us. Honestly, this will last a while. It's concentration, right?
Yeah, but he can only see up to 30 feet.
That's okay. If they're behind a wall, we'll know.
Well, it has a range of 60.
Well, no, the thick walls would block it.
They would?
Yeah, all the detect spells like that are blocked by...
They're all line of sight?
Let's double check. Yeah, let's double check.
Okay. Seems kind of pointless.
Well, like, it depends on how thick the area is, usually. Spell can penetrate barriers, but 1 foot of stone, 1 inch of common metal, or a thin sheet of lead, or 3 feet of wood, or dirt, blocks it.
So the walls are thicker than a foot, I assume?
I would assume so.
Yeah, it looks like it.
In some places.
Okay, well, I'm going to walk up to the chest and open it.
Oh, no. No, James, don't. Please. At least, if your detect won't work, then let's try Jeff's idea of scouting. And also, by the way, I have very good scouting as well.
Well, let's at least try to open the chest first. Because I walked right up to it, and I don't see anything near us.
Well,
that's one way of detecting undead, I guess.
Yeah, the first chamber is empty.
Mark one.
You open the chest.
I was going to check it for traps, dude.
You already did that.
You never told me the result because I got interrupted.
Well, you did it and there were no traps.
Okay.
Yeah, basically you just got interrupted. It doesn't change the fact you know there's no traps.
Okay, is there anything inside the chest?
There is a bluish stone. Hang on, let me find a picture of it.
By the way, Dave and Lee, you guys should put yourselves at full HP.
Oh, thank you.
Okay. While he's examining...
It's kind of like those.
Sorry, I'm back now.
Except the stones are dark blue with light blue circly swirly things.
Oh, good
point. Okay, I'll cast Detect Magic on the stone.
They're hearth stones.
Your vision went from 30 feet to approximately negative 30 feet. You're pretty sure they're magic.
Blinding artifacts.
Yeah, you're pretty sure they're magic.
Well, I'm just going to sit down right in front of the chest until I get my vision back. What little bit I have.
How long does detect magic work?
It's concentration.
Do you stop concentrating?
So now we have an artifact board and some eggs. It is Easter, after all, so I guess that's appropriate.
Who said anything about eggs?
They look like eggs to me.
So I'm not really doing anything right now. I'm just planning out, Tyler.
Okay.
You're just doing what?
I'm just I'm putting these things down, but I haven't actually used the ability. I'm just kind of planning.
Oh, okay.
Tyler, just so you know, I am stealthing. And there's my stealth roll.
Okay.
So, we have two entrances to cover this time, from what I know from being in this area.
Yeah, there's one to the south as well, I think.
Yeah. But I should be able to put barriers.
No, they're going to come back to the front room again. We put all of them in the front room, just like we did the first time. And we draw them there.
Okay.
We have a good choke point there. Let's use it.
Okay.
In fact, if you can, can we find a one that's only five, or can we find a section that's wide enough to be covered by one wall and just cast six of them in a row?
There's not really any that are wide enough to be covered by just one wall.
Can we put it in the center so that there's not enough room for them to go around either side?
So this area right here looks narrow enough that it could be covered by one wall. Like, they couldn't squeeze past it because of the cliff that's right here.
But that's not...
That area right there is already impassable.
Right. So I'm saying is this part right here...
Jeff, no, we're going to go back here again. Just like first time. There's too many entrances in there. There's too many ways around.
So then we're going to have to fire... So
what I'm saying
you'll
is,
have to fly up above is what you'll have to do.
Yeah, same thing as last time.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is we place six of them in a row right there, or right at the narrowest point right here. So that there's not enough room for them to go around the sides. And just place them all in a row.
Yeah, that works. So the rest of us would be behind them.
Here, just do this.
I can copy and paste, right?
Just put a number above it for how many layers there are.
Well, three and three. Or do you just want to have
one wall of six.
Okay. Okay. And then...
See what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
So there's not enough room for them to move around on the side. So you don't place it on one edge like that. You place it right in the center.
You're going to have two.
Why?
They're skeletons. They can shimmy past that.
So we put a body right there.
Okay, look. You guys aren't understanding. All right, so a wall is 5 foot wide, right? Okay. You can place it right there. Okay, there's not enough room for them to move around. Okay, or right there.
It literally has to be along the face of the square.
Okay, the world does not split up into a grid. Not in real life. You can place it any 5 foot section you want. You can rotate your grid any way you want.
Okay. I would agree with that.
That is a very unrealistic way to interpret that spell.
Okay. Then we would basically wind up with a pretty thick...
exactly what I'm trying
block right here.
Exactly what I'm trying for. And we just have a counter down here for how many layers are left.
That works. Works a little bit better. Can you fly, like, basically be above the chest and just launch an arrow down, where's the tool?
See, I have 60-foot vision, so I should be able to see to there.
I can tell you that...
No, I saw him. I already saw him there. Yeah.
Good. Yeah, so basically just launch an arrow in the direction to get them to come after us, while Jodorski and Nissel stand where they were last time.
Yep, exactly. And so it's same time as last time, we just have more layers.
Do I continue to ride your shoulders?
I don't know. Did that work for? It seemed to work fairly well for you.
I thought it worked really well for me. It gave me a good mobile platform to fire off of.
Yep.
In fact, I'm thinking of having us build a...
No saddle.
No, it wouldn't be a saddle.
A bridle?
It would be a platform that we use magic to levitate that you just kind of push. You wear it like a giant belt around you.
We'll talk. I'm really uncomfortable with the idea of a saddle here, I gotta say. Anyway.
Hot dwarf woman wanting to ride you and you're saying no.
No, it's more like Guns of Icarus.
She's got a charisma of 7. Not no, 5, excuse me. No, not hot dwarf woman.
Charisma has nothing to do with physical appearance.
Mm-hmm. It's true, she does have a high con.
I simply have no
skills
force of personality.
Yeah, but that's okay. I'm not in dwarves anyway, so no. Anyway, I fire an arrow at this guy right at the edge of my distance here. Cast my gravity bow first. And we are off. Surprise attack. And
well, I may as well have done a surprise attack along with it, right?
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, makes sense. I think I still missed. Oh, well.
I think you missed.
But it got their attention, which is what I really cared about.
A 20 would have hit on the surprise round, though.
I think.
I'm assuming their flat-footed is higher than 15. Right, Tyler?
That's not good. But yes, it will be higher than 15.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Is it higher than 20 flat-footed?
No.
Okay. 13 points of damage.
To which one? That one?
That one, yeah.
And initiatives.
We're way ahead of you.
Oh.
Okay, I was about to say, these are like the worst initiative rolls of all time, but you're getting a few.
Get all them good rolls out now, Tyler. That's all I gotta say. Get him out now.
Holy crap. I'm glad you picked one of them off earlier.
No, I didn't, unfortunately.
Oh, you didn't? With your crit?
No, that was from the previous group.
This is the group... One of these is the group that you crit.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, you're right. Okay.
Yeah.
I did. Well, you know, we could do cheesy World of Warcraft tactics here. And we pick off one or two each time, run out of the cave, wait for them to reset,
and go back in. I have a feeling if we did that, there might be GM consequences.
Nah, come on. Hang on one sec.
That misses. That will miss. Caine.
Yes.
Your turn.
Okay. I'm going to fire at... Which one did Jeff hit? Or which one did Alisa hit? This one? All right, I'm going to fire at that one again. Nope.
You will fire at it all you want.
And I'm not going to wait for Jeff to fire because he's got way too low of an initiative.
Yeah, don't do that.
We're going to go to here. And we're going to be about 15 feet up.
Okay.
Well, we stirred the hornet's nest, boys. And girls. Let's see what they do.
Well, at least Willem ought to come within sight range.
Sure wish we had a bard giving bonuses.
Yeah, kind of wish he was here. And Grease. Grease with this plan would be amazing.
Grease would be amazing. Sorcerer picked a bad week to be gone.
Oh, I think we needed the healer more than, you know, the grease.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, yeah. But still, the grease would have been nice.
You're also our biggest source of damage.
Alisa?
Yeah.
No, Nissel. Oh, it's my turn.
It's your turn.
No, Alisa.
I'll fire at this one right here. Roll 1d20 plus 8. There we go. 21 hit.
Ooh, it hits.
What? 19 points of damage.
Nice. It falls down, go boom.
Nice.
Boosh. Bones
That's
fly.
Two down.
Yep. For some reason, I when these things explode, I think of like Skeet just going. And the shotgun hits him. Bones flying everywhere.
He charges your wall.
Almost missed it.
I didn't.
Rolled a 5. If it had been anything but a wall, he would have missed it.
He rolled an 11.
Yeah, total.
Ow.
For charging a solid wall, he takes... No.
Okay, so one wall gone. Oh, you've got your counter down there. All right.
Yep. We're at 5 out of 6.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Who's your Jodorski?
Ready in action. First, if any skeletons get through the wall, I attack.
Sorry, this All is probably going to be a boring combat for you, Jodorski. Until they break through, in which case, it's going to be a lot of terror. Real quick.
What you should do, Jodorski, is ready a action to aid another on Caine to give him advice because he can peek around the corners.
That's true.
Do we just have that one guy really close to us?
Yeah. You're not sure.
Yeah.
Wait for the word to do your channel.
Your floating archery platform will tell you when to channel.
Yep.
I will just ready in action.
Okay.
Can you cast magic weapon against evil on Caine?
Oh, yes. Yes. Please. Because I doubt you're going to be able to do your channel this round, to be honest. I doubt they're going to be in position for it.
The wall takes 3 damage.
Wow. Weapons against evil
it
just...
actually survives.
they ignored the DR of evil creatures.
Okay. Never mind. I'm already ignoring it with blunt arrows.
Yeah.
I'm not sure your arrows can actually punch through it at all.
If they're bludgeoning arrows, they are. Oh, the wall, yeah, I don't know.
The wall, because yeah. It has hardness.
Right. Well, if it had hardness, their hits would be bouncing too.
Oh, no, it's hardness 0. Never mind, it's AC 5, hardness 0. Oh,
okay.
So it... But yeah. It's
damage...
You did 6 damage to the wall?
Yeah.
Okay, so now we're down to 4.
Now we're down to 4. Yeah.
But... 3 damage to the next wall.
Doesn't have help.
Damn, how many archers are there?
I saw many.
Caine.
4. Jesus, there's 7 archers. Holy crap. Okay, this is not a plan that's going to work well.
Well, I can... I can... If we can crush the melee ones... The archers don't deal a lot of damage. We can just wait in and stomp them.
But the archers are the ones that are actually hitting you.
Yeah, they're plinking away at us. Though I will admit it's the melee fighters when they hit that do the large chunks.
Yeah.
Well, the archers aren't going to be a big problem. If we can clear the melee, we can just scatter to the sides, like back here.
Yeah, that's true.
And here, and force them to funnel in close.
Yeah, I was just hoping that we could use the walls for a barrier, but it's with all those archers.
We are. Around.
Although, to be honest, Tyler, are they taking the -4 for the being in cover and for firing into melee? That's another -4. Are they taking the -8 to their hit?
Even with the -8, they're hitting the walls.
It's an AC of 5 to hit.
Well, this one. That hit the AC 16 wouldn't have.
Yeah. 8 minus 16 is still 8.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay. Never mind. All right. Fair enough. All right. So I'm going to... This guy is behind some cover, it looks like, because there's something here that I don't know where it is. So it's...
Yeah, that's... Those are like stone pillars... that are actually built into the map.
Okay. Well, I'm going to fire at this guy then. Jesus Christ. Okay. Never mind.
Oh, give me another D20.
Oh, what the fuck is wrong with D20 lately? But it will not give me any good rolls ever.
You've got your perfect aim stuff too, don't you?
Yeah, but I've got it 3 times a day. I shouldn't have to use it when he's sitting right there.
Congratulations, you missed the wall.
Oh, jeez.
Hooray.
I can't even hit the wall. That's pathetic.
Start here, 1, 2, 3. It sunk right into the treasure chest.
6 damage to the wall.
I think another one goes away. Another one. Yeah, these walls aren't going to last long at all.
No.
Well, I mean, we would have gotten another round if he hadn't rolled max damage 3 times in a row.
It's true. My god, he missed the wall.
Maybe.
Yes, well, one. You missed the wall.
I wasn't sure if it might have been over 60
feet. It's a 1.
Well, no, if it would have been over 60 feet, it was a 21.
Over 30 feet, but yeah. Yep, definitely over 30 feet. Uh-huh.
So.
Next.
And now we fireball.
Oh, I wish.
Nothing more satisfying than that spell when they're clumped up like this.
Yeah, no kidding. You almost never get monsters to clump up like this after you get fireball. It's always before.
Yep.
Alisa.
Attack this one.
That hits.
Oh, 12 damage.
Still, you got a plus 10.
I know.
Damage, jeez.
Yeah, so, who doesn't?
Me.
Another wall bites the dust.
Holy crap. Now you channel energy.
Last wall bites the dust.
Now he needs to step forward 5 feet and channel energy.
Why?
So otherwise, even then he's not going to hit him.
No,
he needs to go, like, right here and channel energy, honestly.
He'll die if he does that.
I know. I know.
No. Not necessarily.
No, you know what we need to do? We need to move around the corners so the archers aren't firing at us the whole time. That's what we need to do.
If you channel, we should be able to clean out the melee guys.
Yep, divide and conquer. Bring the melee to us while the archers are moving. Let's do it.
So I would actually move back 5 feet to here.
Yeah.
And channel.
And Jodorski, you need to move to, like, down here.
I'm just going to run in and get him.
No.
No.
Don't.
Please do.
Please.
There's, like, 7 arrows coming your way if you do that.
Yeah, we need to do some corner hopping. Negate the archers for a round or two.
Because if you guys move back and do that, you should be able to clear out these skeletons in a couple rounds. Well, the melee ones.
I'm not so sure about that, but we'll see. It at least doesn't let the archers fire at us the whole time.
All right. Is that skeleton ever going to go?
Oh, he did. Oh. Sorry, I said Jodorski. I just didn't flip the turn order.
So, are you up in the air, Caine?
Yes, I am.
All right, I'm going to step under you briefly.
What are you doing?
I'm attacking.
You can't 5-foot attack and then move.
Yeah.
What?
You can't 5-foot step, attack, then move. You either do a move or a 5-foot step. You can't do both.
I would rather attack.
But you're going to... Dave, you're going to get filled full of arrows if you do. The whole point is to draw the archers to us. If you sit there, they're just going to sit out there and fire at you.
Only for one round. I can survive that easy.
Jodorski, please, listen to reason.
It's that intelligence score.
I'm going to use diplomacy? I don't know. Fuck.
I'm cleaving, starting with the guy.
Dave, don't be stupid. This is bad tactics.
Well, I'll try putting down it.
Is 17 confirm a crit on him?
No.
Okay, so it's only 12 damage for this guy. And 26, I assume, hits this guy for 18 damage.
Does a 23 it's not a crit.
It's not a crit.
Well, there goes our strategy.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Jodorski.
It's the same strategy.
Yeah, we might just have to run out of the cave after. I mean, both of the melee should be at half health.
Nissel! Roll 12.
The only good news about this is all their archers are still going to get a minus 8 to hit. Or, well, no, minus 8. Unless they have precise.
One fail. Yeah. We took out one of the melee. Another 7 damage.
Damn.
Nice.
Very nice.
This might work.
Possible.
Charge next turn.
Okay, if I'm channeling energy... question for you guys really quick.
Mm-hmm.
I'm channeling a healing spell to do damage, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I have a trait called Benevolent Touch. Once per day when you cast a spell or use a class ability that heals hit point damage, reroll any one on the dice and take the new roll, even if it's another one.
Wouldn't work on this, you're damaging.
Yeah. You're not healing hit points.
Okay.
Yeah.
Lee?
Yep.
Wait, there's only 3 right there?
Yeah.
There were only 3, but they were the melee ones.
And this is another reason why I wanted Jodorski to step around the damn corner so that we could gather them all in one place for your channel. But no, he won't be smart.
I just wanted one attack to soften them up.
Dude,
jeez. One round.
This is not good. It was stupid.
It's okay.
Three damage.
Jeez. Let me be the meat shield for once. That is my job.
You've been being a great meat shield. Trust me.
I've been sitting in the back, doing nothing.
Okay. Anyway, well, you're about to be a meat shield.
Well, I mean, there's a tower of 3 of us, so hopefully the damage gets spread out a little bit, and we'll be fine.
There's only 3 or 4 of them. Big deal.
There's 7 of them with bows.
By the way, Tyler, was he within 30 feet?
Holy crap!
Yeah, he's within 30 feet of you.
So the first one hit for 3, and the second one missed.
Yeah, second one miss.
Okay. I thought crit was what landed there.
Oh, it would be if they hadn't moved forward.
Yep.
Miss. Caine.
They really like to fire at me, don't they?
You're up in the air.
Well, so is
Alisa. And Alisa glows with, an awesome power.
Yeah, they're probably scared of that.
Well, they haven't been able to hurt her yet, so...
Well, these don't know that.
You don't know that.
They're a hive mind. They're hive mind skeletons. Neat. Oh, it's my turn. Alright. Well, you know what? I really don't want to be stupid and be a target for archers. I think it's time to draw them in.
You don't want to be a pincushion?
No, exactly. Not particularly. Perfect.
Yeah.
Okay, that hits, I think.
There you go. Nice.
Oh, shit, that was... add one more damage to that, 15 points.
It's dead.
That was the wrong rolls.
I don't think that'll hit Jodorski.
No.
Seventeen's still not hitting you.
Nope.
Doing good.
How about a 25?
25 will hit.
For 4.
Okay.
Charge!
Alright, I get an attack of opportunity on him.
Mm-hmm.
He moved through the third area.
Yep.
Not on a charge, though.
He can't charge for 10 feet.
Nope.
Yeah.
Yeah, you need at least 10 feet.
Oh. Damn it.
Well, you need to be past 10 feet. You need to be at least 15.
No, you need to be 10 or... It's 10 or more.
You have to move 10 feet.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have to move 10 feet to charge. I know this because this was the whole premise of my paladin.
And it has to be a straight line without rough terrain or obstacles. Did he move over that chest?
No.
Okay, making sure. Did he move over some dead skeleton bodies, which I would count as rough terrain?
Yeah.
And so skeleton bodies really wouldn't count as rough terrain.
Absolutely they would. All those bones on the floor are like marbles. That's about the worst terrain you can get, Tyler. Very slippery.
I've been counting it as rough terrain for us, so...
I wasn't counting it as rough terrain for anyone.
Well, it hasn't mattered till now.
Okay, that's fine. Have him attack me. Fine. That's what I'm here for. Yes, that hits.
For 7.
Okay.
Yeah, that was a really kind of a pathetic roll.
Okay. Well, I can't attack this thing effectively, so... Jodorski, I'm going to put a stone wall in front of you, but you should be able to 5-foot step back to attack.
That's what I was planning to do anyway.
So we get a new wall right there.
But it's low enough that I can attack through it, right?
No, if you move,
it'll be down by the time your attack comes around.
Or if you move here, you could attack past it.
Because actually, you that's not necessarily true. Yeah. Oh, that those two are dead. True. Yeah, those two are dead.
Well, the skeletons will probably take it. The archers will probably take it down. But
nope, I get my attack. My attack turn is next.
Yeah, oh, okay. But you could delay, or you could react. As soon as the wall goes down, attack the melee guy in front of it.
Yeah.
No, or I could just move it like right here, and you can just move to this spot right here and attack past it.
Yeah. Which totally negates the point of the wall. Because it doesn't provide him cover bonus at all, then.
It provides Nissel some additional cover.
Okay, yeah. That's true. Yeah, full cover for Nissel. That's good.
Does a 20 hit?
On him, yes.
19 damage.
Jeez.
Nissel.
I am going to move back in the corner.
Okay.
Probably right about there.
Okay.
You want it?
I, I like how I'm basically putting up an ablative shield for us.
Mm-hmm. It's actually a pretty good tactic for choke points.
Mm-hmm.
Oops. 25, Jodorski.
Assuming our fighter wouldn't stand in the middle of it.
Alright. 2 damage.
Okay.
Well, he can retreat and
he could, heal up. But he doesn't.
Well, no, I'm saying next turn, because he's fine right now on HP. Yeah.
He's half down. What are you talking about?
He's one-third down.
Yeah.
So if he falls back a little bit, gets a heal, and then
the point is 19 hit Jodorski
back up a little bit.
The point
more.
Is, if he'd done that last round, he wouldn't be wounded at all. All of the melee guys would be dead,
guys,
just like they were now.
We're fine.
And the archers would have done nothing but move forward.
Guys.
And clump up.
Jodorski does 19.
Down. 19 does not hit.
Okay.
It's AC 20.
Yes.
And if he had, we could have done a channel on all of them next round.
Nope. Caine.
Jodorski, are you going to move down this time?
That was my plan.
Of course, all the archers are still going to hit you right now.
That was my plan. They're not hitting you, they're hitting me.
Well, the point is, I wanted them to not be able to hit any of us, so that they had to do nothing but move and clump up so that we could hit them with the channel. Right now, they can still see you, so they're going to attack you.
They would have done that anyway.
No, they would have done nothing but move forward because they couldn't see anything. If they can't attack, they won't.
If I were an archer, and I had played an archer, I would have moved to the side because I know I could have a range of vision from the side.
If they were intelligent, yes. These things are automatons.
Well, I haven't been acting like that.
Mm-hmm. I'll grant you that, but there is a good chance they would have anyway, in my opinion. But we'll never know. All right. I guess I'll fire at this guy. Nope.
Are you fucking shitting me? It's almost goddamn midnight and you're playing mariachi music loud enough I can hear it in my damn apartment.
No, I'm not.
I mean, I am in South Florida, but if you're going to hear it from here.
I thought I got away from all that BS when I fucking left Omaha.
I mean, you could be in Colorado and have to deal with the pan flutes.
I'll take it over the mariachi.
I can agree with you on that one, actually.
Well, that hits.
Yep.
Luckily, it didn't crit.
4 damage.
Yeah.
Yeah, lucky you weren't another 5 feet away.
And see, the problem with this is now they're just going to stay outside of our range for channel. Jodorski, on your move, can you please just move back?
Yeah, so he's going to move over to Nissel.
That's not back, that's forward.
Well, move to here, just like out of their sight range.
Yes, that was my plan.
And actually, after I attacked, I would have done a 5-foot step this way.
The wall goes bye-bye. No, it doesn't. It only takes 3.
The wall persists.
The wall goes bye-bye. Alisa?
I know. I'm sorry, but we need to get out of their sight range.
Just drop to the ground.
Do another wall.
I create a wall. This time it provides cover for Jodorski too.
Yep.
Okay, Jodorski.
Step, and I ready an attack for the first skeleton I see.
There you go.
Well, yeah. Yeah.
Perfect.
That's good.
Nissel.
Now we wait for them.
Ready in action.
To.
I'll probably just.
Skeleton?
I'll just wait to channel until I decide to do.
Okay.
So you're actually delaying. Okay, that's fine.
Well, I mean, he could say some sort of vague condition that effectively lets him do it when he wants to.
Ready action has to be pretty specific.
Ready in action when whatever number he's comfortable with of skeletons are within range.
That would work.
Wall goes down.
Okay, so part of them didn't move.
How many attacks did it absorb this time, though? Looks like three?
Three, yeah.
That's pretty good.
Nice. What, Tyler?
It's your turn.
Oh, it's my turn. I'm going to ready an action to fire at the first skeleton I see.
Okay.
Come and get us, boys. You can't see any of us.
Yeah, they're completely blocked line of sight.
Which is the whole point. Told you that's what they were going to do.
That's a great action for Jodorski.
And me.
Except only he's in Jodorski's range.
Sure, he is 10 feet.
I can't see it. Oh, never did.
That means I can't. Well, actually, I can, I guess. Yeah, I can.
You ought to be able to see that, Jodorski.
I can't.
That's
I see nice. A line.
Yeah, he has that corner that's blocking him, unfortunately.
Yeah, that corner is blocking my vision.
Good news is the archer can't see him either. Okay, I fire at it and miss.
Alright. Should I draw a line there? I didn't mean to. Sorry.
Yes, you did. Draw a line, that is.
And the skeleton misses. That skeleton misses.
Oh, Nissel might be getting a bunch of attacks going his way now.
That's what I'm afraid of.
That skeleton misses.
Wow, tanking like a boss, Nissel.
Dodge tanking, which is...
Damn.
That skeleton really misses.
Dude.
Alisa.
Okay. So do I want to be clever and put a stone block behind this archer?
Why don't you put one right in front of Nissel?
Because I'll just shoot it down.
Just stop putting them... If you're going to put one up, put one up, like, back here.
Yeah, I agree, actually. Nissel, can you move down to us next round? Like, actually, to right here.
So I put one here?
Yeah. Can you move right here next round? On your neck?
Possibly.
Alright. In that case, I'm going to fire at this skeleton. It's not my move. Never mind. It's Alyssa's move.
So should I put one down or should I just fire at the skeleton?
I think you should ready an action or just fire.
I'll just fire.
We've got a nice little kill zone set up. We should use it.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's a crit.
Nice. Confirm it. Nope. Damn. But it is a hit.
It's definitely a hit.
That is a disappointment.
15 points probably still going to kill him, though.
30 points would have killed him.
Yes, definitely.
Are you sure? That's roughly what Caine did. Yeah, but Caine hit a different skeleton.
Well, you tell us, Tyler. Is it dead?
No, it's not dead.
Okay. Technically, it is dead, but is it dead? Okay, anyway.
Jodorski.
I'm ready in action to attack the first one I see.
Yep.
Nissel.
One, two.
Right here.
Yeah, right here.
Yep.
And then you can heal Jodorski.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, he's damaged?
Yeah, he's halfway dead.
Yeah.
Because he decided to tank.
A cure light wounds would be very good going his way right now.
How much are you down?
Down half the hit points.
No, what like is, actual numbers.
I'm down 17.
17.
Yeah, never do.
You don't have to cure moderate yet, though, do you?
No.
Yeah, I think you get that next level.
But... no, I didn't take that one yet. Okay, I'll cast Cure Light Wounds.
And this will be where we call it a night.
1d8 plus 3.
Melee combat?
Yeah, so we'll start at the top of the round.
Nice. Next time.
Yep, very nice. Oh.
Thank you.
All right, so we are playing next week, as far as everyone knows.
Best of my knowledge.
I'll be here.
I'll be here. All right, James?
I plan to be here.
Alright. And hopefully
Dan will be. The sorcerer who runs in the middle of battle.
And are you still planning on, are you still trying to get another player, Tyler?
Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever happened to Zed?
He can't be here consistently, otherwise I would.
Oh, okay.
Most of the time he works Friday night.
Oh, okay.
Shitty thing about only being the assistant manager.
Yeah, true that.
Well, I'd suggest that we could move it tonight, but every time we do that, it gets really nightmarish for everyone's schedules.
Yeah. Well, if we wanted to look at like either Saturday or Sunday.
No,
I think
Saturdays.
Those start. Yeah, I think Lee, that's your date night, isn't it?
Yeah, and Jeff's running a campaign already on Sundays, so.
Well, my Sunday afternoon, but I couldn't do this late at night on a Sunday.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No.
So okay. Right. No, I might have to. I might just have to pull the hard drive out of my computer. Right now. I have a guy who wants to, but he doesn't have a computer.
Okay.
So I may pull the hard drive out of my old computer so I can wipe it.
Okay.
And sell my old computer for a few $100.
Cool.
Essentially the price of the graphics card that's in it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I gotta go help Karen grab some Costco groceries, so.
Okay.
If we are done, then I will see you all next week.
All right. Yes. Have a good night, guys.
Night.
Take care.
Night.
Good night.